पंकजीत, यू गेट प्रिपेयर्ड। गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। सो टुडे वी हैव आवर ओन प्रेजेंटेशंस ऑफ द कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ विजय तेंदुलकर। साइलेंस द कोर्ट इज इन सेशन। द फर्स्ट प्रेजेंटेशन टू बी मेड टुडे विल बी बाय शंकरजीत भट्टाचार्य जी। प्लीज अनम्यूट योर माइक शंकरजीत एंड स्विच ऑन योर वीडियो। Make your presentation on the character that you have rehearsed.
I am Shankarjit Bhattacharjee. I am playing the character of Mr. Kashikar in Silence the Court is in Session. Mr. Kashikar, I am the husband of Mrs. Kashikar. I am going to play the role of the judge in the play Silence the Court is in Session. Mr. Kashikar is a social worker, but he represents. I am Mr. Kashikar. I am a social worker. I have a wife, Mrs. Kashikar, who is very outspoken, and for that reason I have to every time keep her silent. I have to keep her silent every time for her outspoken nature. So many people think me that I represent a male dominated society, but it is not true. We have no children, but I have adopted a child, Balu Rokre. In present India, the movement of Indians of independence of women is growing day by day, but I have to say, this kind of movement only is harming the society. One of my colleagues, Ms. Lila Benare, is a woman of 34 who is still unmarried, but has a child in her home of Professor Damle, with whom he has a relationship. Thank you.
Thank you, Shankarjit, for your representation of Mr. Kashikar, the judge in the play Silence the Court is in Session. Different aspects of Mr. Kashikar represented by you reveal Mr. Kashikar as a man who is trying to dominate the entire session, silencing almost all the characters of the play and trying to regulate the proceedings of the trial session. Mr. Kashikar is the dominant apparatus for social control in this text. So he is repressing the thought order of others. And yet we find Mr. Kashikar also has his own comic side. So he's almost ridiculous, ludicrous, and we find a kind of split in his personality. So he is also a person who boasts about his power, about his knowledge, and always takes a superior view with his own superiority complex. Thank you, Shankarjit, for telling us all these. Next presentation will be made by Ayantika. Ayantika, please switch on your mic and video and present your character. Ayantika, yes. Yes, we can see you and hear you.
I will present the character of Lila Benare. Hi, I am Leela Benare. I am an unmarried school teacher in my early 30s. I like to have a mind of my own. I want to lead a free, frank, bold, and assertive life. As a teacher, I always maintained a strict discipline. I am also a member of living courtroom. My life of love always lands me in sorrow. At the age of 15, I was exploited by my maternal uncle, and then as a young adult, I committed the same mistake as before. I had been carrying on an affair with Professor Damle, another member of the caste. But after becoming pregnant, he refused to marry me as he is a family man with 5 children. Under the guise of staging the mock trial, I am charged with unwed motherhood. স্যার আমি একটু দেখে নিতে পারি?
ইয়েস ইয়েস ফিল ফ্রি। তো হোয়াট অন্তিকা ইজ ড্রয়িং আওয়ার অ্যাটেনশন দ্যাট অ্যাজ অ্যান আনওয়েড মাদার
ইন দ্য ওপিনিয়ন অফ দ্য কোর্ট আই হ্যাভ টার্নিশড মাদারহুড অ্যান্ড ট্রাই টু ডিস্ট্রয় সোশ্যাল ট্র্যাডিশনস অ্যান্ড কাস্টমস আই হ্যাভ বিন অলসো ফায়ার্ড ফ্রম মাই জব অ্যাজ মাই সুপিরিয়র্স view unmarried motherhood as sinful and was worried whether I would somehow pass on immorality to my students. I wanted to bring up my child with the protection of father and security. I asked some of my courtroom collaborators, Pongshe and Rokre, to marry me but have been rejected. Then I tried in futile to bait Samant. My frantic effort to piece my broken love life together is mistaken by the traditionalists like Mr. Kashikar, Mrs. Kashikar and Sukhatme. I understood that both me and my child will have to face the stigma if it is born without a father and worries about the future. To what extent I am stressed in my personal life comes to the surface when Kashikar jokingly charges me with infanticide during the improvised mock trial, and my collaborators don't miss the opportunity to insult me. At the end, although the caste mates tried to cajole by telling me that it was only a game, but I have been totally broken. My future deliberately left bleak. Thank you.
Thank you, Ayantika Dev, for this excellent understanding and reading of the character of Leela Banare in first person narrative. So we, through your narration, have come to know various aspects of this lady, Leela Banare, who is at the center of this text. You have rightly pointed out that even after the entire assault is made, she is forced to confess her own crime, her sin. And people say that it is just a game, it is just a game. She's unable to come out of that point of torture, stigma, guilt. And indeed, as you have rightly said, that she is a woman who has faced so many problems throughout her life in order to assert what she wants to do, assert her identity in this patriarchal society. She is governed by the stereotypical norms of society and is to be more pitied. She is a tragic character indeed, but also a character to be pitied, more sinned against than sinning. So her sin is a personal one, but this public humiliation and shaming of Leela Banare makes this character a pathetic one. Thank you, Ayantika Dey, for telling us all about Leela Banare.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So, Megha, would you like to say something today about your character?
Yes, sir, I want.
Okay, come on, Megha. Present your character. Switch on your video mode so that we can see you. Yes.
Me, Miss Leela Banare, I am 30 years old and a school teacher. As everyone knows that being a girl child or a girl is not easy task to survive in this world. A girl faces many types of problems during her whole life, just like me. I remember when I was 14 years old child, the brother of my mother came close to me and I found a good person in him, but he just left me after fulfilling his wish. The situation of mine was not understood by anyone in my family, not even my mother. After that, as a grown-up, I fallen in love again and I gave all my devotion and priority to him, but he also didn't want my devotion. He just want my body. And when I came to know that I am carrying a baby in my womb, I told him and he also left me alone for surviving in this society. I am a school teacher, but never taught my students such type of negative things. Everyone who are playing in this courtroom think me wrong, but no one can try to understand my feelings. All of them just judge me for my mistakes. But who they are to decide about my life and my future? I never give anyone the right of taking decisions for me. My life is my own and no one can interfere in this. Everyone sees me as a lady who made sin to make a relation with the married man with 5 children, but no one can look him and told him that being a married man, why he came close to another girl. Not all faults are doing by the girl, but everyone always make a girl wrong, either she is right or wrong. Now I just want a father for my child as I want him to give a good future. I don't need a perfect husband, just a father for my child. I also have a lot to say, but I don't because no one can understand me or my feelings. Thank you.
Excellent, Megha. Excellent representation of Leela Banare by Megha Tiwari. So through you, we understood that Leela Banare has different shades and she is a woman who wants to regulate her life, have full confidence in herself, and whatever she does, she has done that with full knowledge and firm conviction and belief. Although in her earlier life she had had mishap, now she is not regarding this love as mistake. Rather, she is blaming the man who has just been fond of her body in spite of her or his being married, having children. Society blames this woman, Leela Banare, and the stereotype representation of women as either like Mrs. Kashikar, a person who is totally devoted to the husband, like Mr. Kashikar, and the other is the other woman in the life of a family, husband and wife, the other, an adulteress, a seductress, a person who is tempting the man to go off the family line. Leela Banare is accused by the society of committing a crime. First crime of falling in love with Professor Damle. The second crime of giving vent to her bodily desires. Third crime is to conceive a baby outside marriage. Leela Banare wants to regulate her own life, have full control over life, but now she knows that she won't be able to have this because society will keep on interfering. And as Ayantika has just said, that the child to be born, the child needs a father's name, and that is the problem she is facing. So can we regard Leela Banare as an autonomous being trying to have full control over her life, or a person who is devastated by others, forced to come out of herself? All the people around her tell her about her sins. She wants to control her own life and not to be regulated by the words of others. Thank you, Megha, for this excellent presentation.
थैंक यू सर.
सो आवर नेक्स्ट प्रेजेंटेशन विल बी मेड बाय शोहिनी शोहिनी दासगुप्ता कैन यू मेक योर प्रेजेंटेशन प्लीज
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir, and my fellow friends. This is Shohini. Today,
Shohini,
I'm going
please
to.
switch on your video. Video was on.
Yes, sir.
It has become off.
Yes,
Yeah,
sir. Yes, sir.
continue, Shohini.
Sorry, sir. This is Shohini. Today, I'm going to present the character of Mr. Kashikar from Silence, the Court is in Session, a three-act play written by Mr. Vijay Tendulkar. Actually, in our society, we usually forget that we should hate the sin, not the sinner. So Vijay Tendulkar portrayed the picture in this play. Okay, now I'm going to start my presentation. Hello everyone, I am Mr. Kashikar. I do many social works. I live with my wife, Mrs. Kashikar. We have no children, so we have taken Balu Rokhre as a ward. But I don't like him at all. Actually, he is an unpaid servant to me. I don't like my wife as also. I don't like my wife also. That's why I used to rebuke them and I used to say them abusive words. They may say that I am a fault finder, but actually I am not. I misbehave with them because only they are responsible for that. I think my wife talks a lot and I don't like the fact. That is why I have to rebuke them, and sometimes I can't control my tongue, on that time I have to say some abusive words to her. But don't forget that I am a renowned person in our society, so I can do what I want, and I'm happy with my work. I love my work. I'm a judge, and I am happy with that things which I get. That's it. Thank you everyone for listening me, and goodbye.
Thank you, Shohini Dasgupta, for this excellent presentation of Mr. Kashikar's character. So his public life, his personal life, all these are meshed up in your presentation. And we regard this as Mr. Kashikar representing himself on the stage. So his role as a judge, having an absolute command over the situation, also represents his position in the family. And Mrs. Kashikar has been converted into a servant by Mr. Kashikar, a proud man who boasts about his own power and privileges in society and tries to keep this superiority complex, dominating the sequence of action, trying to regulate, and at the opportune moment, even plays in the scandal game in order to make Leela Banare an accused and convict. So Mr. Kashikar's role in the play is, of course, determined by the superior position that a male has, an empowered male has in society. So it is a feudal mindset, it is a patriarchal mindset, it is a mindset of the legal head, the judge who is seated on the citadel of this session of mock trial. Thank you, Shohini, for this excellent presentation. So next presentation will be done by Bidipta Das. Bidipta, please unmute the mic and switch on the video. Make your presentation, please.
Okay, sir. Hello,
Yeah,
I'm Bidipta Das.
we can hear you. Can you switch on your video mode?
Oh, sir, I have some problem, so.
Okay, continue.
Okay.
Hello, I'm Bidipta Das, and today I'm going to present the character of Balu Rokre. So I'm Balu Rokre, and I live with my Mr. and Mrs. Kasikar. The couple adopted me, and they paid for my education and serve as a kind of foster family. And I intended to them acting as their unpaid servant. I am also one of the lowest status member of the caste, a fact which is well aware. And I am frequently ordered around not only by the Kasikar's family, but also the other member of the troop. Before the event started, Ms. Banerjee came to me and স্যার একটু দেখে নিতে পারি আমি?
ইয়েস ইয়েস ডেফিনেটলি। সো মিসেস বেনারে কামস টু ইউ বালু রোকড়ে, দেন হোয়াট হ্যাপেন্স?
ইয়া এন্ড মিসেস বেনারে কাম টু মি এন্ড আস্কস মি টু ম্যারি আস্কস মি টু ম্যারি হার এন্ড লুক আফটার হার চাইল্ড এন্ড রেজ দ্য চাইল্ড, বাট আই রিফিউজড হার আউট অফ ফিয়ার এন্ড আউট অফ সেম অলসো. And obviously, I thought that Mr. Kasikar would be angry with me, so I totally refused her. That's it, sir.
Thank you, Bidipta, for your presentation of Balu Rokhde. So, Balu Rokhde is
Thank
a person,
you,
as you said, much dependent on Mr. and Mrs. Kasikar. His voice is muted, silenced by the patrons and oppressors, and we have the stories that are strung all together in the story of Leela Banare. The confession that Balu Rokhde makes about Leela Banare is also related to the position of Leela Banare in society. She cannot become a single mother. She needs the name of a father. And Balu Rokhde is the chosen one. Balu Rokhde concocts a story about Leela Banare and slapping Leela Banare. That is a worst thing. Even Leela Banare is somewhat responsible for her own suffering, as we see. So in this play also we find she is playing with Balu Rokhde, calling him names, Balu, Balu, like this. She is taunting Balu Rokhde. So Balu Rokhde is presented by Leela Banare as fragile, as a weak, as a vulnerable, as a dependent being. And she wants to give empowerment to Balu Rokhde through this marriage proposal, which Balu Rokhde definitely rejects. Balu Rokhde's rejection of this proposal is also guided by his own prejudice regarding the patriarchal values. He says that in his entire family, no one has done such a sinful thing. Therefore, he rejects Leela Banare. Thank you, Bidipta, for this excellent presentation of the complex character Balu Rokhde. Balu Rokhde is also a person who is more sinned against than sinning in this play. Thank you for this subjective as well as affectionate reading of, sympathetic reading of Balu Rokhde's character. So our next presentation will be by Debojyoti Ghosh. Debojyoti, please unmute your mic and show your video face, photogenic face to us all. Please make your presentation. Yeah.
Hello everyone present here. This is Sukhatme, a prosecution lawyer in the play, but swatting flies in real life. I'm a part of this amateur theater, Sonar Moti Tenement Progressive Association, Mock Law Court, and I'm also a part of the living courtroom. And since both Damle and Raute were absent on the day the play was performed, I have also performed the role of a defense lawyer. I enjoyed having power in a fictional living room. When I was offered the role of a prosecution lawyer, I just couldn't resist myself and accepted playing the role of a prosecution lawyer. Because what happened if I couldn't perform in real life, but in this play perhaps I could exercise my power to its fullest. All my colleagues, my co-actors may call me a sadistic or a misogynist, but trust me, I feel immense pleasure in humiliating others. And when it comes to mock and accused women, I never leave a point in targeting them. While I was prosecuting the accused Miss Leela Benare, I felt that women like her are given too much independence. And that is unjust and unfair, rather a disgrace to the society, because it should have been rather Nastri Swatantriya Marhati. According to me, woman stands and resembles the holy motherhood, and motherhood is pure. Therefore, a greater nobility in our concept of motherhood, we have acknowledged woman as the mother of mankind. I have also said that woman is a wife for a moment and a mother forever. And a woman like Miss Leela Benare is not fit for this society like this. I couldn't let her case have a different viewpoint, so I said in the courtroom that when there's a woman in the dock, the case doesn't have a different complexion. I also added that no allowances must be made because the accused is a woman. The reason behind this is that I felt that men and women are perceived in the public sphere entirely on the basis of their gender. I hold high traditional views, and you may see me as a mirror reflecting the patriarchal male-dominating society. I have tried best in upholding my supremacy and negative emotions throughout the play. And now I leave this entirely to you all, my audiences. Thank you.
Thank you, Devojyoti. Thank you, Sukhatme. But I must judge the excellence of your analysis of your own character. Why are you so vituperative? Why are you so indifferent to the plight of persons? Why do you interfere too much in the life of others? You said that you take sadistic pleasure.
Yes, sir. Then
why? What is the reason? What can be the possible reason? Are your own failures in your own life, personal life?
Yes, sir. Because the negative impact on my life has made me do such things. I feel happy by taunting others, by making fun of others, by commenting on themselves.
So you by nature is a misanthrope, is a misogynist. You by nature is sadistic. All the bad qualities are there. And yet you regale, you get enough joy, enjoyment, happiness in enacting such things. Don't you feel pity for persons like Leela Benare?
To a certain extent, while studying the case further, I did feel that. Later, it's my nature itself. I couldn't let down my egoistic character fall in front of a woman like her.
See, so
as I have said earlier too, that a woman shouldn't be given much independence. And she had enough of her independence. She misused her independence to a much less extent.
Yeah, Sukhatme, you have presented your viewpoint. I understand. But Sukhatme, don't you think that your own personal failure in life, you are a briefless lawyer, you don't have a case in the court, you are a part of this theater group, you have got histrionic talents, and you have always got the best of the roles in the plays that we perform as a group. And
yes,
yet,
sir.
Why do you victimize individuals? Why not let them live their own life? Why do you interfere in their lives?
Because, it makes me happy.
Okay. It makes you happy. You derive enough sadistic pleasure. Most of people in society, they derive pleasure at the cost of others. The suffering of others, they do not deem it important. And they take immense pride and privilege and happiness in insulting others. So you are shaming Leela Benare in the play. So do you think
yes,
that
sir.
This is justified? Shall we regard you as a villain of the play? Sukhatme?
Yes, sir.
So we regard you as a villain of the play. And much
because
of the,
I did act as a act myself with much negative impact within me. And I have tried to keep it intact within me while the play was going on. I have shown myself that yes, the negative character I have played much. I didn't allow myself to show positivity, to show sympathy to Miss Leela Benare.
Okay, thank you, Devojyoti, for this excellent reading of Sukhatme's character. Thank you. So our next presentation will be by Anjula Haldar. Anjula,
yes, sir.
Yeah, make your presentation, please.
Hello, sir. I'm Anjula Haldar. I'll be presenting the character of Balu Rokre here. So, hello. I'm Balu Rokre. I'm the young, adopted, ordinary child of Mr. and Mrs. Kashikar. But others may find me a slave of them, as they always listing orders to me and abuse me no matter how hard I try to please them, especially Mr. Kashikar. Sometimes plays not and joins Mr. Kashikar, her husband. However, work with them at Mock Law Court and with others, including Ms. Benare, Shukhatme, Pongshe, and Karnik. They are all self-earned person and they are self-earned persons and they're free. And I often wrote down their quotes while they as a symbol of freedom, like I use their words to make a way of freedom. However, once Ms. Benare offered me an opportunity, she offered me a marriage proposal, but I refused it proudly, kind of, because I think that would be an agreement to me again. I have to play the non-honored person. I have to play the role of a non-honored person again, and a household husband with a beautiful working lady bearing a child, and the child she is bearing, I cannot claim that to be mine, and neither I love Miss Benare or nor she loves me. So the society that Mr. Kashikar always teaches us will mock me even louder this time. So, but and again, I don't like Miss Benare personally, because I don't like a lady of free will. I rather want to marry a lady like Mrs. Kashikar, who even supports her husband when he is wrong and rude. And sometimes I think that I may never be out of this maze, because I am happy that I have a family, but this has become a burden, and I may never ask for it if this would this has to be the result. And the feeling of being in this family sweetens the feel, because when I think of being alone in this labyrinth, that freezes me out. So I think I'm habituated of this dependency, being with everybody else and being suffocated, like, and I think I will be like this forever. And this is Balu Rokre. Thank you.
Thank you, Anjula Haldar, for this analysis of Balu Rokre's character. We believe what you said, and we start having this conviction that Balu Rokre is a person who is a trapped man in this moment of slavery. And his own infatuation for Mrs. Benare that you rejected. You have some infatuation,
yes, sir,
for Mrs. Benare. You have some... Balu Rokre, you do have some infatuation for Lila Banare. You admire her freedom. You love her. And this is a secret. And you find in Lila Banare the utopian world of freedom and autonomous self. But yet you admire Mrs. Kashikar. And when you plan to marry in future, you will always aspire for a woman like Mrs. Kashikar.
Mrs. Kashikar, yes.
Mrs. Kashikar, yes, you said that. Who will be obedient, who will serve as a housewife, and will definitely support you your own credentials. But you are also a person who is educating yourself with the words that are said by characters, different characters of the play. Whenever anyone says a good line, you keep copying. You also carry,
yes, sir.
You, instead of Gita, you have carried Oxford Dictionary. So you are a learner, perpetual learner. You want to perform roles in the play, but you are not allowed. Mrs. Kashikar is not allowing. Perhaps Mrs. Kashikar is too cruel towards you because she herself is not allowed to perform in the plays. So when you get the opportunity of performing play, you offer yourself as a player, you say, but Mrs. Kashikar doesn't allow you. So you are still under the control of Mrs. Kashikar. So the opportunity that you got of liberating yourself from the confines of Mrs. Kashikar, you saw this as merely an exchange of one kind of imprisonment with another kind of imprisonment. Thank you, Indrila, for telling us all this about Balu Rokhde. So through these multiple readings of Balu Rokhde, through so many scholars with us, we have seen that Balu Rokhde too performs a very important role in the play and is a very complex character. Thank you, Indrila.
Thank you, sir.
Next presentation will be done by Indrila Day. Indrila, please unmute your mic and switch on your video. Make your presentation. Yes.
I am presenting the character Mrs. Kashikar. Hi, I am Mrs. Kashikar, wife of Mr. Kashikar, who is the chairman of the dramatic troupe. I use my married title, Mrs., and my husband's surname is my only public identity. I wanted to be an excellent mother by raising children, but my married life with Mr. Kashikar has not been blessed with a child. So I and my husband, Mr. Kashikar, have adopted a boy by the name Balu Rokhde to drive away the boredom of our domestic life and for our security. I want to lead a very happy life together. I buy a garland for my hair and shirts for Mr. Kashikar. I always address my husband as dear. In order to spend my time with my husband in a constructive manner and also to drive the boredom at home, I have become a part of this dramatic troupe organized by my husband. I know all the members of the troupe very well. When Sukhatme decides to stage a trial to while away the time till they perform their regular show, I suggest to change the accused. Though Mr. Kashikar opposes my idea, Sukhatme approves it. I tell Saman that the lighter part of the court proceedings are only for fun, and in the real court, such things are not allowed. I encourage Balu Rokhde to come out with his witness without any fear of anyone. I have some trouble to absorb the idea of modern women taking to career and remain unmarried. In this way, they spoil the society with their immorality in the name of so-called freedom. In my days, girls used to get married irrespective of their complexion and features. I cannot tolerate young unmarried women singing, dancing, laughing aloud, and running after the company of men. I find something wrong with Miss Benare when she left secretly with Professor Dumley. Miss Benare does what she wants. She has economic security. She goes for a job and earns enough money to lead an independent life. But I don't have such independence to act without my husband's permission. I approaches Miss Benare and asks her to get up, telling her that everything told about her is untrue and it is just for the sake keeping the game go on. I alert to get up and wash her face and get ready for the real show to begin in another 5 minutes or so. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Indrila De, for this analysis of Mrs. Kashikar. Through your representation, we got a clear picture of Mrs. Kashikar as a woman who belongs to the traditional concept of Indian mother, Indian wife, Indian woman. So she had her own aspiration for becoming a mother after having the opportunity of marrying Mr. Kashikar. But she is now leading a life without a child. She has adopted Balu Rokhde. She has to compensate her own failures in life, her sterility or the sterility of Mr. Kashikar, the boredom of this monotonous relationship, marital relationship with Mr. Kashikar. She also has to safeguard Mr. Kashikar from the allurements of women like Leela Banare, the educated, independent, free-willed woman who can dance, laugh, sing. Although you do not like Miss Banare's activity, there is always a subtle fear in your mind that someday or the other Leela Banare might take away Mr. Kashikar from you. And this crisis in your life, if I'm not wrong, Mrs. Kashikar, has made you participate in this cruel game that people play in order to shame others, in order to secure their own being. Usually in comedy, we find that misfits are punished. In this tragedy, Silence the Court is in Session, Leela Banare is presented as a misfit, especially with reference to Mrs. Kashikar. So you are presenting Miss Banare as a misfit who should not have remained unmarried till this late age of 34. A woman who should not dance, who should not sing, who should not have an independent life of her own. Although she herself is controlled by patriarchy, she is unable to understand the aspiration of a female like Leela Banare. So, Anjula, thank you for making us understand these different shades of the character that makes
Mrs. Thank you, sir.
Mrs. Kashikar so interesting to us. Thank you. So, our next presentation, Oyun Chatterjee, will you make your presentation now?
Yes, sir. Just okay. Sir.
Yeah. Switch on your mic, please, and speak your phone on.
Hello, am I audible, sir?
Yes, yes, you're audible and visible. Please make your presentation, Ayan.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, sir. Today, I'm going to present the character of Pongshe from Vijay Tendulkar's Silence, the Court is in Session. So, first of all, I'm Pongshe. And I have some issues that is bothering me in my life. I know it is none of anyone's concern around me, the people around me, but what I have felt about myself, I'm going to tell you guys. Basically, I'm a clerk and a member of the living courtroom, and I couldn't get my degree because I failed in the middle of the period, and I have some insecurity regarding the existence of myself within the boundaries of the society. I have few known colleagues and co-employees working around me, and I try to pretend my existence by degrading them and degrading anyone that tries to come close to me. Every time I feel that I am getting cold behavior from someone, or I'm getting something like friendship or some warm attitude even, I feel like degrading them and insulting them so that I can prove myself in front of them. This is, I feel, due to my lack of confidence on myself, lack of dignity over myself, and I feel some inferiority complex around everyone else. Even when I liked Miss Banare, who came to me with a marriage offer. I rejected that because I felt that I am being dishonored, disrespected, derogated by her offer, because I thought that it is kind of a desperate move from her side, and I rejected the proposal. Even though I had some feelings regarding her and all that mellow stuff going on with myself, I couldn't take the step and say yes to Miss Benare while I had the chance. People think of me as someone rude or someone like a very arrogant person, but in reality, I'm just a person who is suffering from heartbreak and temporary influx of existence. I would say about myself, last of all, that even though I act rude around people and arrogant around people, I don't feel the same way about all of them in my heart. It is just that I have insecurities about my own existence, about my own stance in the society. That's why I choose to take the defensive mode and insult and derogate others just to prove myself right. Thank you for letting me present myself.
Thank you, Pokshe, Oyon Chatterjee. So Pokshe was more visible in your analysis than Oyon Chatterjee. We forgot for a moment that this is Pokshe or Oyon. So this is what we play when we enter the character. Thank you for absorbing the character of Pokshe. We were waiting for Pokshe for a long time. And through you, we started learning what Pokshe is. A very complex character in the play. As you have well absorbed the character, understood the nuances of the character. Personal failures in life, his inter-fail, he's working as a clerk. He almost resembles like mere salt of the outsider, Albert Camus' work, Outsider. So this person is going through an existential crisis and finds himself in an absurd situation. This outlet for him, the outlet in the theater house, for him is a kind of expression of the self, while he's also carrying his own unresolved complexes in his personal life. So this entire thing that the play presents, the split between the appearance and reality, that reality has been well expressed by your psychological reading of the character Pokshe. Thank you, Oyon, for leading us into the complex mind of Pokshe.
Thank you.
Pokshe, you have been participating a lot in the games in order to assault Lila Banare. So you are also infatuated towards her. You admire Lila Banare's beauty. You admire her presence. You are secretly in love with Lila Banare, but you cannot accept the marriage proposal that she offers. What can be the possible reason for this?
The possible reason behind this can be that I am not sure about my own feelings, whether I really like her or love her, or it is just an infatuation, or is it that by her offer that she wanted to marry me, it is just a mode of disrespecting me or something like that. I'm not sure about what is going on in this particular thing, in this particular situation.
Okay, you may not be sure about your own feelings towards Lila Banare, but if Lila Banare had given you an indecent proposal, other than the marriage proposal that she gave, if any kind of indecent proposal if she had given you, would you accept, Pokshe, would you accept Lila Banare's indecent proposal? Like sure. Professor Damle also accepted Leela Banare did not agree to marry if the same proposal of any kind of relationship was offered by Leela Banare, except marriage, would you have accepted that? I'm asking Pokshe.
No, sir. I wouldn't.
You would not have. So your life is controlled by your own desires or by society? What others will say about you?
Sir, mainly society. That's why I act very defensive around everyone.
And you think that offense is the best defense in most cases?
Yes, sir.
So you are so offensive, cruel, like Sukhatme.
Not like Sukhatme. Sukhatme is different. I'm just trying to save myself. I'm not trying to hurt anyone deliberately, sir.
Okay, you say
I'm just trying to stay on my stance and prove my existence around everyone.
So you say that Sukhatme is more cruel than you, and you are mainly protecting yourself. And this outer shield that you have kept, like the snail's shell, that is for self-protection. Then why did you participate in the game of cruelty against Leela Banare?
Because when she offered me the marriage proposal, it struck me with a tone of disrespect. And I wanted to take some revenge on her by hurting her to some extent, to some levels. And
okay,
this girl would do that.
That marriage proposal hurt your self-dignity, sense of self-respect?
Yes, sir. Because
okay, thank you.
Knew about her and Damli, and that she was going through a tough situation about her pregnancy and all of that. And when she offered me the marriage proposal, I thought it is out of sheer desperation that she wanted to provide the child with some good good future. And and giving me the proposal would help her doing that. So I thought that she was very self-centered, selfish when she proposed me, and I felt very disrespected.
Okay, from this hurt feelings, you wanted to avenge your own suffering. And whenever the occasion came, you participated in the game of cruelty against Leela Banare. Thank you, Ayon, for this excellent reading of Pokshe's character. So I am really impressed by these multiple readings of the characters through so many different perspectives. And you are all participating in the same game of analyzing the characters. Someday or the other, if we get opportunity, we'll perform the play on the stage with such excellent actors. Thank you, Ayon.
Thank you, sir.
So our next presentation will be done by Sunanda. Sunanda Shingho, you can please unmute
your
mic. Yeah. Make your presentation, please. So
okay,
can you
sir.
Take your media mode on?
No, sir. I have so many problems.
Okay. Continue, please.
Okay, sir. Good afternoon, all of you. Good afternoon, sir. I am Sunanda Sinha. I am playing the role of Karnik. I am a experimental theater actor and the other side member of the Living Courtroom. I feel proud for the drama. Drama is my focus. Drama is the only way to awaken the social consciousness of the people. So here this play, the many characters are there, Leela Banare, Sukhatme, Pongshe, and the others. I was very happy to do this play. So that's why this character in our drama, Rokhre, I told him that the mic batteries are all right. So because last month I'd been in the middle of our show, a fuse blow. So for this thought, the hall would put even a real code to same. So I seems to have less of a personal emotional stake in the outcome of a trial because I am less conservative politically than Kashikar Sukhatme, who see the trial as a referendum on independent women. I know that something is wrong in Banare's personal life related to pregnancy, but I have no any real interest in attacking Banare for her behavior. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Sunanda Sinha, for your excellent presentation of the character of Karnik.
Yes, sir.
Experimental theater actor.
Yes, sir.
You are influenced by so many ideologies of theater performances. You talk about enactment, visual enactment of the scenes. The real life games that are being played in the rehearsal, you participate in that game. And from the perspective of an experimental theater maker, you want the realism that has to surface, psychological realism that has to surface. Although you say that you do not have any personal grudge against Leela Banare.
Yes, sir.
Yet you participate in the game of insulting her, humiliating her, and also give some witness regarding her past life. Why do you think that your attitude towards Leela Banare has changed suddenly? You are very progressive, I suppose. But why do you participate in the game of cruelty against Leela Banare? Yes, why do you participate? Do you find some kind of sadomasochistic happiness out of this cruel game of punishing Leela Banare? So you say that visual enactment, real life and fiction, there should be a gap between it. It is us to make the things visible. Even support Fatme performing dual role, the lawyer for the accused, the lawyer, prosecution, lawyer. So you support that. And when you get the opportunity of participating in this game, you also participate as a witness. And in the most theatrical, operatic manner, you present the story of Leela Banare, the secret story of her personal life, and participate in this game of shaming. Game of shaming, public shaming. So trial that is taking place in this play, Silence the Court in session, is on different levels. Trial within trial. So Leela Banare is forced to pass through this trial and tribulations and subjected to such forms of cruelty that she had never thought of. When she began in the play with Saman, she was so comfortable and she was planning to leave herself in this world of freedom, the theatrical freedom that offers her some kind of liberty from her personal pains and suffering. So Sunanda, your presentation was excellent. We have learned from you about the different aspects of Karnik. So
thank you, sir.
Willingly or unwillingly, you also are part and parcel of this game of cruelty against Leela Banare. So you are an experimental theater maker of cruelty, and you enjoy a lot. Although you are introvert, you also enjoy a lot playing such games. Thank you, Sunanda, for this excellent analysis. So can we have Mumita? Mumita, please unmute the mic, turn the video on.
Sir, I told already.
Yeah, you have presented, but we have only one or two. Okay, Reshmi, are you ready for the presentation? Reshmi, today can you make your presentation of any character from Tendulkar's play?
Sir, this is my first class.
I understand. That's why I'm asking. Are you ready to play the... No. So next session, we will wait for you. Select any character from this play. Make the presentation. Okay. Pragati, Vishash?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yeah. Pragati, please make your presentation.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Pragati Vishwas. I am playing the role of Pokshe. I am Pokshe. I am a member of living courtroom. Although I am a failure in real life, I am performing the role of a senior scientist. I am a middle-aged unmarried man. I worked as a clerk in the Central Telegraph Office. I don't like when people like Rokre laugh at my education. That's right, that I have nervous breakdown, nervous temperament, and without my pipe, I can't remember a single thing. It was my idea to accuse Ms. Banare for the crime of child infanticide. She was beautiful, and I also fascinated by her charm. And sometime I used to gaze at her secretly, but she proposed me to marry her. Not because she liked me, but because she was pregnant and she want me to become father of her child, and that was an insult for me. I am not so worthless. And she also made fun of us behind our back. Yes, when she make fun of Mr. or Mrs. Kashikar, or said Shukat me a poor barrister. I enjoy it a lot, but I find her silly. She was not mature enough to be my wife. Besides, sometimes I find no sense in her action, like sticking out her tongue like a lunatic. And I know there was something wrong with her, and I was right. Besides, this mock trial was just a game. It did not cause any real harm to her. Thank you.
Thank you, Pragati, for your analysis of the character of Pokshe in such an excellent, in-depth, profound manner. You have also absorbed the character of Pokshe and presented the different shades of his character, the complexity of his character. So being deprived in your personal life of so many opportunities that you got, that you aspired for, having failed in your studies, doing the job of a clerk in an office, and being always observed by others, your life is being controlled by others. So your assertion of self-will is hardly present. Although there is a secret infatuation for Leela Banare, you cannot express that. And when Leela Banare offers you the proposal of marriage, you rejected that. So this is an excellent reading of the character of Pokshe. And through your analysis, we also found that Pokshe is also a character drawn from a typical situation and represents a person from the Indian milieu. So who is a typical person who is also universal. And people like Pokshe, they roam around. He is also a part of this theater group. And in this theater group, he has his own role to play. And he always has this tendency to show off whatever he wants to. And in order to hurt the feelings of others, he also has this plan of revenge. Thank you, Pragati, for this presentation. So
thank
today
you,
we had such an excellent reading of so many characters of the play. So anyone left? Anyone has to say anything about some character? One character is left, but players are not there to perform that. All of you have already done your job? Yes, those who are present, 18 students are present now. All of you have done your job, have presented your characters?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I will be asking you some questions, specific questions, okay? Some specific questions related to the art of characterization in this work. So would you consider the characters of Vijay Tendulkar something new, something strange, something uncommon? Yes or no? Would you consider the characters of Vijay Tendulkar unique? Something new, something strange, something that is not seen in other text, literary text, or you are not familiar with, unfamiliar characters.
Sir, I found some similarities between the characters of Leela Banare and Jimmy Porter of Osborne. To some extent, or maybe this could be a far-fetched one, but if I judge both the characters psychologically, sir, am I audible?
Yes, yes, audible. Continue.
Jimmy Porter.
Is a part and parcel of the Angry Young movement of John Osborne's play Look Back in Anger.
Yes.
Jimmy Porter talks about his anger against society. He wants to hear a warm, thrilling voice cry out, Hallelujah, Hallelujah.
Exactly. And sometimes we find Leela Banare also saying such things that people should laugh, people should dance, may sing in the first act.
Okay,
and
independent free will is expressed by Leela Banare and also by Jimmy Porter, according to you. So we do accept, appreciate you for this comparison. My question was something different. My question was that, do you know these people? Are you familiar with these people? Or these people look strange to you? The characters in this play.
Sir, I have a question.
So I asked a question. Please respond to that question first, then I will hear your question.
So these characters are very familiar with our own society.
Okay, okay. That is what I was asking. So these characters are known characters, not unknown
characters.
But characters were presented in some way so that you know more about the characters. This is Tendulkar's typical art of characterization. He will draw characters from typical situation, from typical life, typical characters, and place them in the dramatic text. But through that, he will also try to break the stereotypes of the character. So characters are presented first as stereotypes. A clerk is a clerk, a person who is an experimental theater maker is an experimental theater. Mrs. Kashikar is a traditional housewife. Mr. Kashikar is a traditional feudal patriarchal boss. Okay, powerful man. Sukhatme is a lawyer. So these are all typical characters. Lady Leela Banare is a person who is working as well as earning her own livelihood as a school teacher. So apparently they are typical characters whom we know. But in the play, when they are set in this dramatic conflict, in this action, gradually what is revealed is a complex character, complexity of the character. That means his task is to unmask the character. So when you found these characters unmasked through your readings of the characters, do you find these characters interesting? Realistic characters. Did you find these characters interesting and realistic?
Yes, sir. Somewhat realistic and also interesting at the same time. Many of the characters really show their intensity as they show in our today's society. Like Mr. Kashikar, he is the typical judge-like person, as we often interact with the elder ones of our society. They told us how to do everything according to the rules and regulations of our society.
Okay, thank you. Shankujit, your question, what was your question?
So my question was, all the male characters in this play are mocking Miss Banare. All the male characters are mocking Miss Banare and they are representing the male-dominated society. But this is strange to me that Mrs. Kashikar, being a woman, mocks a woman who is in such a worst situation of life. It is very strange that being a woman, Mrs. Kashikar, who is very elder, very much elder than Miss Banare, mocks her.
Shankujit, what is your question? This is your observation. I appreciate your observation.
Sir, actually, it was my observation, not my question.
Okay. So, similar observations you can make. Thank you, Shankujit, for your observation.
Sir, I was saying something.
Yes, Ronita, say.
So I was saying, you were asking about how relatable these characters are to us. When I read first Met, when I first read Macbeth, I found the character of Macbeth quite similar. The psychological changes that takes place, and similarly here, these characters were quite round characters. The way they develops, they were quite relatable.
So interesting reading. You find Macbeth as relatable as the characters of Silence, the Courtesan Session. So one is the Scottish setting is Scottish. People are unknown to us, historically also removed. These characters are more contemporary, and you find that there are similarities. Both the characters can be regarded as relatable.
So yes, what sir, do you they think? Are relatable.
Is it because of the psychological universality of the characters?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, psychological universality of the characters. So, are these characters more Indian than Macbeth?
Yes, sir, probably because they are written in India or by an Indian writer. I think the people have been described in a manner more like us.
Okay, when we talk about Shakespeare, we do not try to analyze realism in Shakespeare. Realism is a genre, especially with reference to theater, that came late.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, we do not usually say realism. Rather, we talk about the psychological verisimilitude of character, like the reality. Okay, Aristotle yes. also talks about this, like the reality. Vijay Tendulkar's play, do you think that this is Aristotelian play or non-Aristotelian play? Macbeth is partly Aristotelian play. But would you consider this play, Vijay Tendulkar's play, as Aristotelian or non-Aristotelian?
I'm not sure about it.
Aristotle, simple. The definition of tragedy is given by Aristotle. Definition of comedy is given by Aristotle. Tragedy he defines as an imitation of an action that is serious, complete in itself, having some magnitude, with a beginning, a middle, and an end, presenting a character, a tragic hero, who is usually a person of noble birth, having some kind of consistency, okay, like the reality, and will be placed in a plot that will dominate. A plot which will present this tragic hero in a state of happiness, and this tragic hero will commit an error or hamartia, and then there will be a reversal of fortune. The entire thing will turn against him. What he has thought of or she has willed will simply turn against him or her, and finally there will be a discovery, a recognition, a kind of anagnorisis of what error has been committed. And after that, there will be the downfall of the tragic hero. This is Aristotelian concept of the tragedy. My question is, would you consider this play as Aristotelian play, tragedy, or a non-Aristotelian play?
Sir,
yeah.
When our protagonist in this play, Banari,
talk about your character. This is the character that you are playing. Would you consider your character as a tragic character in Aristotelian sense?
To some extent, yes, sir. Because the way that they come up, I think yes.
Justify yourself as a tragic hero or heroine.
Sir, in the beginning, we don't get to know these characters that well. Later, while each other, they point out about one another, their defaults, their living defaults.
Okay, how many of you think that your character is a tragic character? How many of you?
Sir, I don't think Leela Benare is totally of Aristotelian character. Because for her case,
I don't also think that
for her case, Leela Benare doesn't go to any anagnorisis. Anagnorisis doesn't happen to Leela Benare. She never commits her crime that she has had committed some illegitimate or illegal kind of acts in her life. She always thinks that whatever happened to her is not her fault. throughout the whole play, and even in, at the end we find she never commits her crime at all. So there is no anagnorisis happens to Leela Banare. There is
why,
no self revelation.
No anagnorisis is happening. Anagnorisis is a stage of discovery. At the stage of discovery, the tragic hero understands that the path taken by the tragic hero was a wrong path. After the peripetia, the reversal of fortune, the tragic hero understands the idea or the thought or the plan that the person has done or taken has been a wrong one. And there is a sense of repentance for that act. So Leela Banare is more tragic because of this. What she thought?
Leela Banare is not a wholesome tragic character. She is a flat character, not a round one.
See, round character and flat character, these are two different terms used with reference to novel. In case of drama, all the characters are round characters, three-dimensional characters. Okay. By flat character, E.M. Forster meant character who has been presented from one dimension. Okay. The presentation does not give any kind of objective correlative to that character. Side character, minor character, not fully developed character. But in case of drama, say a servant character comes and carries a luggage on the stage and then leaves. He can be regarded as a flat character. But most characters who participate in the drama, okay, whom we can understand, they are all round characters, psychologically convincing characters. So Leela Banare is definitely a round character, a psychologically convincing character. My question was that how many of you think that you, the character that you played, performed, are tragic characters? That was my question. How many of you think that you are a tragic character? I will just give the opposite also. Opposite the character that is used in comedy. Comedy, Aristotle said, is a representation of action that is ludicrous, of the ridiculous, of the ridiculous, of the ugly, not causing harm or pain. Okay, this was Aristotle's definition of the comic character. I repeat, comic character is a person who is ludicrous, ridiculous, ugly, whose act and conduct is against the traditional norms of society, and yet that misfit does not cause any kind of general harm to society. This particular misfit in case of comedy is rectified. And through this process of rectification, either the expulsion of the humors that Ben Jonson talks about, every man in his humor, every man out of his humor. So the expulsion of humors, the shortcomings of human beings, by exposing the faults of conduct, of manner, these people are rectified. So my second question will be, how many of you, means how many of your characters are comic characters? First question is, how many of you regard yourself as tragic characters in Aristotelian sense? And the second question is, how many of you regard yourself as a comic character in Aristotelian sense?
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Sir, I have a question that how Leela Banare is a tragic character, because she lacks the grandeur of the tragic character as Aristotelian rules. So she's not a grand character that makes a tragic flaw and then faces the reversal of fortune and then anagnorisis. I don't think so. I think, sir, Leela Banare is a pathetic character because she repeats her mistake once again.
So my question, you have avoided my question. I asked you a question. How many of you, the characters that are there in the play, regard themselves as tragic characters?
Sir, can I say something?
Just a minute, I am responding to Ayun. Okay, Rishabh, please.
Okay, Rishabh, sir. Okay, sir.
So how many of you think yourself as comic? This is a modern tragedy, okay, modern play, a social tragedy. We can see that Leela Banare is presented as a non-Aristotelian tragic hero. Okay, non-Aristotelian tragic hero. I agree with you, Ayun, that she does not pass through different stages like hamartia, peripeteia, anagnorisis, and finally catastrophe. And with Sudeshna, I can agree that yes, Leela Banare is passing through these stages. She has committed an error, hamartia. There is some reversal of fortune. There is a peripeteia. And although I do not agree that she is a flat character, I say that she is a round character, psychologically convincing character. She has all these stages in her life. Aristotle was talking about the place that he had seen in his poetics. He was not trying to prescribe any rules for tragedy. On the basis of the place that he saw, he gave a poetics, a definition of tragedy, classifying tragedy into different types, or drama into different types, like tragedy and comedy, and further classifying the different aspects, elements of tragedy. So Leela Banare, what is her condition at the beginning of the play? We find her in a state of happiness. Happiness? Yes or no? Ayon?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
At the end of the play, she is in a state of sorrow, suffering.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. At the first scene, she is in a state of ignorance.
Yes, sir.
She's oblivious about the mechanisms of society.
Yes,
she thinks
sir. Yes.
That her life is her own. She has full autonomy over her body, over her mind, and she can regulate her life. So she can trap summons, she can trap someone else. So she can control over her situation. Although she has committed a sin, she thinks she can overcome that. And she wants to bring the baby. And she thinks that her autonomy or will allow her to deliver the baby and live a mother's life by getting hold of a husband, giving the father's name to the child. So she has this confidence at the beginning. She is in a state of ignorance. Towards the end, she understands that she will not be allowed to stay in her private world. She will be always regulated by others. She will be exposed. She will be shamed publicly. And finally, she will be forced to abandon her will to give birth to a child without a father. And once exposed, once she is publicly shamed, we assume that the poison in her hand will be used, or she will go for abortion of the child. We assume this. That means she will be committing infanticide. So she moves into a state of knowledge towards the end. And this knowledge is a terrible understanding of the human position. Therefore, we can say that, yes, this is a modern tragic hero. If not Aristotelian, this Leela Banare also commits a hamartia. What is the hamartia of Leela Banare? Yes, Rishabh Dev, you had an observation. Please make your observation.
I have played the role of Mrs. Kashikar. So I think Mrs. Kashikar is just a victim, not a tragic character or comic character. And I think Leela Banare's hamartia is falling with love with Mr. Damle. And
that is her hamartia. So hamartia, according to Aristotle, has to take place on the stage. It cannot be the past event. Oedipus pushing his father to death, pushing Laius to death, is not hamartia. Okay, it has happened ago. Okay. So hamartia has to happen in the plot of the play. Oedipus stands at the beginning and says that I will clear the darkness. Whoever has killed Laius, I will search that person and I will cure this land from that blemish of that sin of that murder. So hamartia, even in Macbeth, hamartia is committed in the play when Prince of Cumberland's name is announced as the future king of Scotland. Macbeth says that this is a step on which I must fall down or else overleap. So he has two roads to take. One first road is to kill King Duncan. The second road is to accept whatever the position is. He has become the Thane of Cawdor. So these two choices make Macbeth to commit hamartia, to select one path.
Sir, can we say,
sir,
says that I'm more sinned against than sinning. I'm more sinned against than sinning, that I have not done something so terrible, that my suffering has become so terrible. In Lila Banaras' case, you say that her act of falling in love with Damle is the hamartia.
Because this is the error of judgment.
Play, error of judgment in the play is not that, because it has happened earlier. That has already happened. Okay, hamartia cannot be that.
Okay.
Hamartia is a step taken by the tragic hero. So what do you think is the hamartia in the play of Lila Banaras?
Sir, I think Lila Banaras' hamartia is she is making fun of other characters constantly.
Specifically, okay. When she
sir, I can't hear you.
Yes, Angela, you are saying something?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Especially when Lila Banaras calling Rokra as Balu, that is the ultimate point when Balu Rokra puts allegation against, put evidence against Lila Banaras.
So Sudeshna and Anjula both have pointed out serious flaws in the characters of Lila Banaras. I do appreciate. A tragic hero has flaws. Okay, hubris is there. By nature, the characters has flaw. So being too independent, too conscious, self-conscious, she is also a narcissist. She is also a sinner. She is also critical of others. She plays with the life of others. So Samant comes on the stage and Samant is told a lot about the characters. Hand that rock, the cradle. Why should she make such a comment? Mr. and Mrs. Kashikar, they do not have a child. So this childlessness of Mr. and Mrs. Kashikar has been revealed to Samant. Who is Samant? Samant is just an outsider. So she is also playing with the life of others. And the hamartia is that in spite of playing with the life of others, she thinks that her life is her own. Can you get the meaning clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is her hamartia. So in spite of playing with the life
I think Lila Banaras is similar to Kashikar. I mean, how Kashikar is a dominant, Lila Banaras also wants to be a dominant like him for according to a modern modernization type.
Okay, I mean, modern dominant matriarch she wants to become, a free woman, independent, economically independent, educated.
Yes, sir. She wants to be an anti-patriarch.
Okay, feminist. You say feminist.
Yeah.
Wants to assert her female will.
Yes,
Mr.
sir.
Mr. Kashikar is trying to assert his male will and Lila Banaras is
When there was no one, when she is alone with Samant, and Samant is an innocent village guy, so she wants to put the modern female feminist mindset, she wants to input that feminist zeal into Samant. But when Kashikar and along with others they came in, she became helpless under those three or four members.
Okay, I accept your understanding of Lila Banaras' character. So can we say, with focus on Lila Banaras, she's a sinner or a person who is sinned against? I said King Lear also says this. I'm a man more sinned against than sinning. I'm a man more sinned against than sinning. So would you consider Lila Banaras as a man, as a woman, more sinned against than sinning? Or would you consider Lila Banaras as a sinner? So think about this topic, okay? I leave it to you to ponder on this topic. And next day when we meet, we will discuss. Some more characters are left. An important character, Samant, has not revealed himself on the online platform. So we will learn about Samant. And next day we will discuss about plot and character, okay? The relationship between plot and character that I introduced today. Aristotle stated that plot is the soul of tragedy. Okay, character secondary. in this play, we find the dominance of characters rather than plot, because there is no plot at all. Everyone is plotting the plot in Silence the Courtesan Session. Okay, there is no plot, absolutely no plot. And when the characters are all involved in framing the plot, making the plot, we find it strange that how is it possible? We find it strange. How is it possible for the plot to dominate over characters? Which is more important, the plot or character? So in our next day's discussion, we will try to relate plot and character. And through this relationship, we will also try to trace Tendulkar's method, theatrical method, that we called theatricality, Vijay Tendulkar's theatricality. For your secondary reading, I can prescribe a few books if you want to follow. Shall I prescribe or shall we go for a reading of the text? Because the comments that you made.
Sir, volume, please.
Yeah, I say the comments that you made on the characters, individual characters, I find these comments better than the critics. So would you have the confidence in yourself, in your autonomous will, creativity, critical answers, or would you depend on other critics? So historiographic research has to be made by you. Historiographic research can be done by you. That part you can do, definitely. But analysis of character, art of characterization, or say the relationship between plot and character, these you can handle. Some books are there on Vijay Tendulkar's works. If you want, I can prescribe some of these works. And if you don't want, if you want to just follow the text, which one? You want to follow the text? Or?
Sir, please prescribe the book.
Sir, please, Bolun Boi.
So first is the introduction, Oxford edition introduction that we started with in our first class. Okay, the Oxford anthology introduction is there, short introduction on the play. Follow that. So there are so many good works. For secondary reading, you can read Babu M. Sarath's Vijay Tendulkar's Reader's Companion. A Reader's Companion is there. So you can also read a book called Vijay Tendulkar Silence the Courtesan Session, edited by Nilanjan Chatterjee, published by Imprint. Professor Nilanjan Chatterjee is an excellent study of the characters of the plot, play within a play session. A short history of Marathi theater is also given. So I can show you the book also if you want to see. So this book is an excellent. So can you see? Yeah. Silence the
Yes, sir.
By edited by Nilanjan Chatterjee. Imprint publication. Imprint publication. This book contains analysis of characters, of plot. Okay, you can follow this book. I am using this particular textbook. Okay, Silence the Courtesan Session, the same textbook that you are using. In this textbook, you have this introductory chapter. Okay, this introduction. This introduction is very helpful for writing the answers. Okay, read this introduction. A short introduction, but it's very helpful introduction. Go through this introduction. I have discussed this introduction in the first lecture. Okay. Another work, I have seen the Theatre of Power by Smita Paul. Theatre of Power by Smita Paul. Okay, this is a Booksware publication. You can see a Booksware publication, Smita Paul's Theatre of Power. You can also follow this book. This book is also a good analysis of the plays of Vijay Tendulkar. Okay, apart from this, you can also go for the reading of the other works by Tendulkar if you want, for making a comparative study of the works. The play that comes closest to Silence the Courtesan Session is Ghasiram Kotwal. Even Vultures, the Gidda, that play also comes very close to the text. Arundhati Banerjee. Okay, Arundhati Banerjee, she has an excellent essay on the play Vijay Tendulkar and Theatre of Cruelty. She makes a comparative study of Vijay Tendulkar Silence the Courtesan Session. So you can go through this work also. Vijay Tendulkar's silence the courtesan session as a theater of cruelty. So we have the cult of violence and cruelty in modern theater by C. Coelho. In that work also we find some study. Regarding Marathi theater and Tendulkar's contribution, you can go for a reading of Vibhid Deshpande's A History of Modern Marathi Literature. Then we have N.S. Dharan, the plays of Vijay Tendulkar, published by Creative Books in 1999. It's also a good text. So in the journal Indian Scholar, there is a essay by P.D. Dubey, Vijay Tendulkar, Silence the Courtesan Session. So secondary reading, we also need some basic books in order to understand the play. Basic books, say Aristotle's Poetics, I have referred to that. Theatre of Cruelty by Antonin Artaud, if you want to read. Knowledge and Power, okay, Foucault's understanding of knowledge and power. And some feminist essays, contemporary feminist essays, you can follow in order to understand the text. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.